Hello guys, and welcome back to the channel. Now guys, there's nothing at all in this news that portends good news for Nigeria or Nigerians, especially Nigerians in the southern parts of the country. So this news that I am about to bring you are the drumbeats that is going to herald, that is heralding the next 4 years under this Buhari administration. So this is the precursor of what the next 4 years is going to look like under Malam Buhari and his cabal. So with that guys, I bring you this. Buhari, Saudi prince agree to establish Nigeria-Saudi council. So that's the headline. Buhari, Saudi prince agree to establish Nigeria-Saudi council. Now let's see exactly what's going on here. President Mohamed Buhari on Thursday in Riyadh accepted an invitation from the Saudi crown prince Mohammed bin Salman for the establishment of Nigeria-Saudi council aimed at promoting investment and enhancing relationships between the two countries. The decision was the highlight of a bilateral meeting between the Nigerian leader and the crown prince, which took place on the margins of the Future Investment Initiative conference. The meeting, according to a statement by the senior special assistant on media and publicity Malam Garba Shehu, was initially scheduled to hold in the office of the crown prince, but out of courtesy and respect for the Nigerian leader, Prince Salman insisted that he would meet the president in his hotel at the Ritz-Carlton Riyadh. The council will be made up of our government officials and business leaders from both countries, and the areas of focus are economic growth and development, investment in oil and non-oil sector, and security cooperation. President Buhari and the Crown Prince agreed that the first assignment for the Council is to establish a legal and operational framework that will facilitate investments beneficial to both countries. The Council will be established in the next 2 months, whilst meeting will be held twice every year. To ensure that the relationship between both countries remain active, it was also agreed that leaders of both countries at the highest level will meet at least once a year to review the progress of the joint council and ensure closer collaborations on issues of mutual interest. President Buhari thanked the Crown Prince for the kingdom's interest in investing in Nigeria and the initiative to establish the council, which would form the foundation for a stronger Nigeria-Saudi relationship. Nigeria has a very large population, mainly made up of dynamic young people, and partnerships of this type will help them to be productive and prosperous, the president said, assuring that his government will continue to provide the enabling environment for businesses to thrive in the country. Speaking on regional and international issues, President Buhari shared the view of the Crown Prince that with the collapse of ISIS in Iraq and Syria, the next frontier for terrorism is the Sahel region. The Nigerian leader commended the concern by the Saudi authorities to keep the issue of security situation in the Sahel region on the front burner. Earlier, the Saudi Crown Prince had noted that the security challenges in the Sahel should be seen as a global issue. Saudi Arabia is prepared to participate in the engagement and sensitization of the whole world to the problems of sub-Sahara Africa, he said. On bilateral issues, the Crown Prince reiterated the preparedness of the kingdom to support Nigeria's development agenda, noting that the country had the potential to be amongst the top 20 economy in the world. Saudi Arabia is eager to support Nigeria, and we want to be a part of Nigeria's journey to be among the top 20 economies in the world, he said. Prince Mohammed bin Salman told the president that the Saudis have invested $40 billion in India, $10 billion in Pakistan, $20 billion in Indonesia, and are willing to do the same in Nigeria, given the favorable business environment. The Nigerian president re-emphasized that enabling a conducive business environment will remain a priority for his administration. So now this is now the going on now in Saudi Arabia, where Buhari is at the moment. So he's speaking to this Prince Salman. So I started with a cautionary note for this video. So now let's revisit that caution that I was trying to signal to you guys. So we have to first start, of course, with this Prince Salman. And what you think of this Prince Salman, the name that immediately comes to your mind is Khashoggi. We all remember the Khashoggi story, what happened to him in Turkey at the instructions of this prince. And this prince, of course, has his hands in virtually a good 80% of the goings on in terms of wars and whatnot going on in the Middle East, Yemen, Syria, etc. His name is always linked and is actively a participant in the goings on in that region. So you now have him wanting to have a presence in Nigeria. Now, this has very grave implications for Nigeria, if you ask me, because this guy, Prince Salman, in many people's view, is a religious extremist. He's not only a religious extremist, he's also a factional extremist. So, he's an extremist in terms of the religion that they practice in their region, but he's also a fanatic of a particular faction of that religion. So, effectively, he's a Sunni fanatic, is effectively what I am saying. And then if you look at that and you transpose it on a global stage, you see all of his activities trying to promote that particular agenda globally. You would recall, of course, and if you don't know, then it is the case that there are two factions within the religion that they practice, which is the Sunnis and the Shiites. Now, the Shiites are the Iranians largely, because the concentration of that Shiite movement is within Iran, and the Sunnis really are the vast majority of that religion. And it repeats, of course, within the Nigerian locality. We have it locally within Nigeria as well. So you know, of course, of the going on between Malam Buhari and Sheikh El Zakzaki. So Sheikh El Zakzaki is, of course, of that Shiite belief system, and Malam Buhari is, of course, of the Sunni belief system. We've already seen the interplays that is going on in that little microcosm that we have within our country. So now this alliance now that this guy is now forming with Malam Buhari is really portending grave clouds for the Nigerian space, because if you think about it, this guy is a fundamentalist and Buhari has fundamentalist tendencies as well. Nigeria has the largest population of black people in the world. So if he's able to capture Nigeria via Buhari, then that is really dark clouds for the nation, and especially, of course, the people who are not of his faith, because he's very fervent about his faith. You have to remember, of course, that that faith comes from his domain and he has oversight over that faith. So if he's now taking charge of Nigeria via Buhari, then really this is really something that is very cloudy for the Nigerian space. And you have to look at the details of what they are agreeing as well. They are talking about investment in non-oil and oil sector. So first, the oil sector is really what we have to focus on, because the oil sector really is the only thing that Nigeria has to offer anything or anyone. If you remove oil, then Nigeria doesn't really exist. So that oil sector first is something that they're going to target, and they are targeting now in this now bilateral relationship that they are establishing along the Sunni lines. So this is the first area of concern, because if they are able to get hold of the Nigerian oil wealth in a significant way, and they have 4 years to do that, by the way, because you now know that we're under Buhari now for the next 4 years. If they are able to do that, then that is really pretty much taking seizure of the country. And then you have to also remember about 2-3 years ago as well that Malam Buhari signed an agreement that aligned the Nigerian forces to their forces in some sort of anti-terrorism collective to under the guise of fighting terrorism. So we already have that in place. So they are now firming this up effectively now, because these people, they have a lot of money, and if they open up the oil sectors of Nigeria to them, they can just very quickly take it over, and if they have a legally binding position, there's really nothing that Nigeria can do about it. If they are now saying on top of that that they are cooperating on the security front as well, then you'd have, of course, exchanges of Nigerian militaries with the Saudis, etc., and then you start to feel a Saudi presence within the Nigerian the security forces structure. And then what does that then portend for people who do not follow or believe in a Saudi type of system? So dark clouds is what I see as being the upshot of this particular thing that is going on. And the real nail in the coffin, of course, is that they have 4 years to flesh it out. So the next 4 years is going to completely change the face of Nigeria one way or the other. There's absolutely no question about that. And if you think it's going to be changed for the better, then you and I do not share the same point of view, because I do not think that. Whatever your thoughts are, though, come share them with me in the comment section. Nigeria is now forming this alliance with Saudi Arabia. What does this mean for the country, especially the southern regions? This is really where my concerns are. Come tell me what your thoughts are in the comment section. Before you do that, click on the red subscribe button so it turns gray. The bell button notifies you every time I drop a new video. Then come tell me about this alliance that Malam Buhari is forming with the Saudi prince in the comment section. So I'll leave you here. Join me in the comment section, but here I say peace.